Hello everyone, today I'm going to present you my mini project about the course EE102. It's a digital design course, and in my project I will present you a piezo vibration sensor and its application to a VGA monitor and basis to connectors. First of all, I will show you the circuit. It's the general circuit. Here is the vibration sensor, piezo. Its model is MiniSense 100. And here is the analog part, the second breadboard. You can see it's the analog part that is needed for vibration sensor to give input to ADC. And now I will talk about the shim of that part. Here you can see this. In this part here it is our sensor. There's a resistor in front of it. There are two diodes that look to up part. Here we give positive 12 volts and negative 12 volts to the op amp here. This op amp takes symmetrical voltage values from those, and this is the input to the third part of the op amp IC. We connect 2 and 6 together, and after op amp our piezo sensor has high impedance in its output part, so this op amp makes that high impedance lower, and we can get values to the input of the ADC. Here is the time constant part. This diode makes we take both positive and negative values to the from the sensor, as the vibration voltages can vary between negative and positive, but this diode makes us only take positive values, because ADC can get only positive values to work. There are resistors and capacitors here. You can vary it with a time constant tau is equal to RC. You can get a value. This value makes when vibration sensor gives a voltage, for example 3 volts, this part makes it going down lower in a higher time interval, and after this part the output of the vibration sensor goes to ADC directly, and we can go to the circuit again. Here our vibration sensor gives about 30 volts, but this diode here is limited to about 5 volts, and because of that we can take up to 5 volts. It's needed because ADC cannot work with higher voltages. And here I will show the simple circuit. This is our sensor. This goes to op amp. We get voltages, and then our time constant, and this finally, after all, this goes to ADC. Then in ADC we have many inputs and outputs. We have CS, read, write, int, like those. They are all coded in the VHDL language, and we have many other GNDs and VCC. This VCC is supplied by 5 volts. It's adjusted with a voltage regulator, because we use 12 volt in the first part, but with a voltage regulator we can lower it and use it in ADC. And we have 8 inputs to the basis 2 board. basis board. And bases have leads, 8 leads in it, on it. And the code comes from computer. According to the code, the voltages vary from the sensor, and according to our 8-bit input, the leads get values between 0 to 255, and according to those, according each 32 bits, each led lights up, so we can get 8 levels of vibration voltages, and those voltages also goes to monitor with VGA, VGA, and finally with the help of pins, we have another breadboard, and on that breadboard we have three inputs, each two levels of vibration. We have three LEDs and three buzzers. These are connected, and with each when the voltages reach all those levels, different LEDs and buzzers appear. And now we can go to the project. Here is the code. I have clock divider, as you can see. I have VGA controller code module, and I have top design module, as you can see. Here these are the parts that is used to write like nothing, no panic, take care, and alarm writings on the monitor with the help of VGA. And as you can see, there are 8 different levels of voltages. In each voltage level, for example, in the first part, buzzer outputs are 0. In the second part, one of the output is 1, and the second is 1 in the other 2, and in the last 2, the other is 1. And we can now see the project. I have worked it, and here finally it is the pins assignment code, the code for basis 2 FPGA. And finally this is the project. As you can see, here we have a vibration sensor, and from this part the ADC give values, 8 bit inputs to bases, and we can see, for example, here it writes nothing because we are in the first two levels, so we have no vibration voltage. But as you can see, when I hit this, for example, in the second, when it sees the third and fourth part here, it says no panic, and here the green LED and this buzzer works. When it goes to fifth and sixth levels, the second yellow buzzer works, and the second buzzer just gives sound. And here, as the voltage lowers in a higher rate than the third and fourth voltages, we cannot see directly the take care sentence here. In the fifth and sixth part, it tries take care, and in the final seventh and eighth part, it writes alarm. The colors also are adjusted with that. The blue part is the lowest one. According to this, the green part is the second, with no panic. Yellow one is the third with take care, and the red one is the final with alarm. And here it was my project. This sensor works with this heat normally, My aim was creating a simple seismograph, like detecting earthquakes, but throughout my project, the sensor was not working very well throughout the end of the project. So with this heat, I cannot see voltages now, but with a new vibration sensor, we can get a better voltages. And that was my project. Thank you for listening to me.